Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about right hand rule and right hand screw rule for direction of vector product. In right hand screw rule, first let us see, or first we are discussing a simpler version of it, that is right hand rule actually here. Consider two vectors, one is vector A, another one is vector B, lie in the xy plane. You just imagine that xy plane is the plane of this paper. Okay, and the angle between this vector A and vector B is actually given as theta. Then the vector product of two vectors is again a vector, no? Okay, that is we can write vector A cross vector B is equal to some other vector, vector C. And we are trying to find out the direction of vector A cross vector B, that is we are trying to find out the direction of vector C. See, here the first vector is vector A and the second vector is vector B. So to apply this rule, to get the direction of vector C, we just want to use our right hand. Okay, you just want to use your right hand. Then what do you want to do? We just want to open up our right hand palm and place it on vector A. This is vector A, this green one. So we want to place our right hand palm like this on vector A. Okay, or along vector A. We should not place our palm like this. Okay, in this situation the palm is parallel to the plane containing vector A and vector B. Alright, or it will be almost like that, no? So, or it will be like parallel to vector A. What we want to do is, we just want to place our right hand, okay, like this, so that our palm is perpendicular to the plane containing vector A, or our palm is perpendicular to this line, this vector which is shown like vector A. Okay, then we just want to curl our fingers. We just want to curl these four fingers pointing from vector A to vector B. That is, to curl our fingers from vector A to vector B, we want to curl them in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so we want to curl our fingers through the small angle in this, like this, from vector A to vector B. Okay, so when we curl our fingers from vector A to vector B, the stretched thumb, this thumb points in the direction of vector C. Okay, the stretched thumb points in the, when we curl our right hand, I mean first we just want to keep our right hand like this, then we want to curl our right hand from vector A to vector B, that is in the anti-clockwise direction. So the stretched thumb points in the direction of vector C. And we want to curl our fingers from vector A to vector B through the small angle, that is theta here. When we consider any two vectors, vector A and vector B, here the angle is given as theta. But there are actually two angles between vector A and vector B, no? One is theta as marked here. Another one is this angle. This angle is also between vector A and vector B. Okay, and what about this angle? This angle would be 360 degree minus theta. This is theta, so this would be 360 degree minus theta. Why or how? See, angles around a point add up to 360 degree. So if this is theta, this would be 360 minus theta. Okay, so while we are applying right-handed screw rule, right-hand rule for the vector product, the rotation should be taken through the small angle or smaller angle which is less than 180 degree between vector A and vector B. So here the smaller angle is theta now, so we want to curl our fingers through that small angles. We should not curl it from vector A to vector B like this in the clockwise direction. We should curl it in the anti-clockwise direction through the small angle. So, when we curl our fingers from vector A to vector B, the thumb points in the direction of vector C. Okay, that is vector C will be along this direction. Okay, my thumb actually points in the direction of vector C. So, vector C would be along this direction. Okay, that is that vector C is actually directed out of the plane containing this vector A and vector B. That is in the outward direction. Now, what about vector B cross vector A? We got vector A cross vector B is in this direction, that is in the upward direction, or it is directed out of the a plane containing this vector A and vector B, that is, it is directed out of the plane of this paper. Now, what about this vector B cross vector A? To get the direction of vector B cross vector A, we just want to open up our right hand palm and place it along vector B. Okay, that is, vector B is the first vector here and vector A is the second vector. So, we want to curl our fingers from first vector to the second vector, that is from vector B to vector A. So, if I am keeping my right hand like this on vector B, this is or along vector B, I will be able to curl my fingers from vector B to vector A like this, that is in this direction, from here to vector A. But that should not be done, because the curling of fingers should be done only through the small angle. We should keep our right hand palm like this and curl the fingers from vector B to vector A, that is in the clockwise direction actually. Curl the fingers from vector B to vector A, that is in the clockwise direction like this, through the small angle theta. So you can see that my thumb actually points in the direction which is into the plane of the paper. Okay, if I am keeping my right hand like this, right hand palm like this, along vector B and curling my fingers, that curling is actually through the larger angle. That should not be done. We should keep our right hand palm like this along vector B, then curl the fingers from vector B to vector A through the small angle theta, that is, curl the fingers in the which direction? Clockwise direction. So your thumb points in the direction of vector B cross vector A. So, my thumb actually points in the direction which is into the plane of the paper. So, the direction of this vector product, vector B cross vector A, is into the plane of the paper. Okay, so this is the simple version of right hand rule to get the direction of cross product or vector product. This is actually the rule of the right hand, or right hand rule for defining the direction of vector product. Now, let us see the rule of the right-handed screw for defining the direction of the vector product, vector A cross vector B. Okay, so here I have a screw. Okay, you can see here I have a screw and two vectors are here, vector A and vector B, in this plane. Okay, this is the plane, a plane of the paper which contains vector A and vector B. To get the direction of vector product of these two vectors, vector A cross B, that is, vector A cross B is equal to vector C. So, to get the direction of that vector C, we just want to turn the head of the screw. This is the head of the screw and this is the tail of the screw. So, we just want to turn the head of the screw in the direction from vector A to vector B. Okay, that is, from vector A to vector B means in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, then the tip of the screw advances in the direction of vector C. That is the rule. The tip of the screw, when we turn the head of the screw from vector A to vector B, the tip of the screw, this is the tip of the screw that advances in the direction of vector C. That is actually the rule. So, let us see. See here, this plane is actually the plane containing vector A and vector B. For better understanding, I am just keeping like this. So, this is our plane which contains vector A and vector B. I have a screw here. Then, to get the direction of vector A cross vector B, this is the first vector, vector B is the second vector. So, we want to move from vector A to vector B, that is, we just want to turn this head of the screw in the anti-clockwise direction. So, let's see what happens. Okay, you can just use your common sense to get a better idea about this actually. 1 minute. I think it is clear to you. I think you can see that screw. Alright. So, see, I am just turning the head of the screw in the anti-clockwise direction. So, please see what happens to the tip of the screw. Okay, the tip of the screw tries to come out from the plane containing vector A and vector B, no? Okay, that is, when we rotate this in the anti-clockwise direction, it is just like loosening the screw. Okay, so the tip of the screw that comes out of the plane containing vector A and vector B. That is, when I turn the head of the screw from vector A to vector B, that is in the anti-clockwise direction, the screw comes outward. It is just like loosening the screw. That is, the tip of the screw tries to come out of the plane containing vector A and vector B. Okay, that is, the tip of the screw advances in the outward direction So the direction of vector C is perpendicular to the plane of the paper and it is directed out of the plane containing vector A and vector B. So here the plane containing vector A and vector B is this plane. So the direction of vector C would be perpendicular to that, that is in the outward direction. Now, to get the direction of the vector product vector B cross vector A, we just want to turn the head of the screw from vector B to vector A. That is vector B, I hope you can see this, vector B is here, vector A is here. While we are trying to find out the direction of vector B cross vector A, vector B is the first vector, vector A is the second vector. So we want to turn the head of the screw from vector B to vector A, that is in the clockwise direction. Okay, so here please see, I'm just turning the screw, okay, from vector B to vector A, that is in the through the small angle. Through the small angle means that is in the clockwise direction. Okay, so turning the screw from vector B to vector A means turn it in the clockwise direction. So what happens then, please see what happens. The screw moves into the plane now. Okay, see, it was, okay, it was like this initially. Then when I turn the head of the screw in the clockwise direction, you can see that the tip of the screw moves into the plane. Okay, that the screw advances in a direction which is in the plane or into the plane containing vector A and vector B. The screw advances in that direction. Okay, that is into the plane. So the direction of vector product of vector B cross vector A is into the plane containing vector A and vector B. Okay, so in this plane, into the plane means it will be having a direction like this. So in this video, we have discussed about the right hand rule as well as right hand screw rule for the direction of vector product or cross product. I hope you understood this. Thank you.